Good morning, everyone. This is Shyam, Assistant Professor, Civil Department, in Chapral Engineering College. Subject: Estimation, Specification, and Contracts. Unit 3: Earthworks for the Roads and Canals. On topic: Earthwork Estimation Problems. So, previous class we discussed the types of estimation. To find the volumes in different types. Today we discuss the problems. So earthwork estimation, cross section of the earthwork of roads in banking or in cutting is usually in the form of trapezium. So here banking portion and cutting portion. This is the formation in roads and canals also. So here earth surface, it is the banking portion. So this is the side slope s:1 or n:1. This is the side slope distance sd. Here base or breadth b and depth is the d, and side slopes sd, second side slope, and ratio is the s:1 or n:1. So here it is divided in two parts. One is the rectangular shape, another triangular shapes. So one rectangular plus two triangular shapes. Here calculated area and volumes. How much quantity of the banking portion? Similarly, here how much portion of the cutting portion in quantity or volume. So here there are, we discussed the four methods in earthwork estimation. One is the midsectional area method, second one mean sectional area method, and third one trapezoidal formula method and prismoidal formula method. Prismoidal formula method, another name Simpson's rule. So we go to the problem. Write the problem. A canal is in cutting and has a width of 4 meters. At the bottom, if the depth of cutting is 2 meters. And side slope 1.5:1. Find the area of cross section. This is the problem. Here we find the area of the cross section. So area of the cross section is formula b plus nd r sd into d, means bd into nd square. So here in this canal is the cutting portion, means cutting, given cutting width and depth and side slope. So cutting diagram is this is the cutting portion. So here divided two parts. One is the rectangle portion, another two triangular portion. Here side slope n:1 or s:2. s:1, sorry. So here side slope n:1. Here given the depth is cutting depth. 2 meters and base width is 4 meters. So here base width is 4 meters and end side slope is 1.5 feet. Here given data. So width is 4 meters and cutting depth is 2 meters. And depth is 2 meters. So substituted in formula cross section of area, A equal to B means 4 plus N means 1.5 is 2 and 2 D means 2 total multiply with 2. So here 1.5 is 2, 1.5 is 2, 3, 4 plus 3 into 2. That is equal to 14 square meters. It is the area of the cross section. Clear all of you? This is in cutting portion, same filling portion, same procedure. Next we go to the second problem. Find the volume of earthwork in embankment of height, sorry, length 12 meters and top width is 5.5 meters and depth is 2.5 meters and side slope area 1.5:1. So here width is, top width is 5 meters. Next one, side slope is 1.5:1. And depth is 2.5 meters. So here depth 2.5 meters. Here we find the volume of earthwork. Previous problem is we calculate the area. So here volume is area into volume, length. That is equal to volume or quantity. So write the given data. First of all, top width is B equal to 5.5 meters and depth equal to D equal to 2.5 meters and side slopes 1.5:1, that is 1.5. It is the N or S. Next one, length is 12 meters. So area formula is BD plus ND square. This is the area. Volume formula, area into L. So area formula BD plus ND square into L. So BD value is 5.5. into D value is the 2.5 plus N value is 1.5 and D square 2.5 square into L. Length is 12 meters. Here given data, length is 12 meters. Substitute, then finally volume is 77.5 cubic meters. This is the volume or quantity of the earthwork. Okay, clear all of you? Next problem, the depth at two ends of the depth two ends of an embankment of roads of length 70 meters are 2 meters and 2.5 meters. The formation width and side slopes are 8 meters and 2:1 respectively. And estimate the quantity of earthwork by mid-sectional area and mean sectional area. Mid-sectional area and mean sectional area. Here quantity find the, means quantity means volume. Volume in mid-section and mean section. We find out So first of all, given data, write the given data. So base width is 8 meters. It is the formation width, means base width 8 meters, and length is 70 meters, and different depths are 2 meters and 2.5 meters, means D1, D2. D1 equal 2 meters, D2 equal to 2.5 meters. So draw the figure. Here different depths, here one depth is 2, similarly same end portion, here depth is 2.5. So here base width is 8 meters and length is 70. Next one, side slope is 2:1. Here first we find the midsection area and quantity. So first B equal to 8 meters and D1 equal 2 meters. It is the D1, and another end is the D2, and length equal to L 70, N equal to side slope 2. So first here different depths. So one is the 2, another one is the 2.5. So here taking the mean depth. So mean depth means DM. DM equal to D1 plus D2 divided by 2. So 2 plus 2 divided by 2, that equal to 2.25. Here mean depth. Next one, midsection area, AM equal to BD plus ND square. BD means mean depth, DM, and NDM, mean depth. So B value 8 meters and DM 2.5 meters plus N value side slope 2 into DM 2.25 square. Equal to 28.125. Next, volume of earthwork, AM into L, area into length. This is wrong. Only 2 into 2.5. Next one, volume of earthwork, AM into L, 28.125 into 70. That is equal to 1968.75 cubic meters. It is the volume or quantity of the earthwork in midsectional area. Okay, clear all of you? Next, mean sectional area. Mean sectional area means second method. Here individual areas find out, previous case in direct average of depth taken, mean depth. here mean area taken. So first of all, area of cross section at one end. One end. So first one. One end BD. B means 8. Similarly, B same 8. And height is depth means 2. Here second one 2.5. So side slope is given 2:1. So E and E and distance 70 meters. So first one, area of the cross section at A, 1 N. This is indicated area. A1, second one is the area. A2. So A1 here. PD plus N D square. So here one area D1, it is indicated to D1. So BD1 plus ND1 square. B means 8 and into D1 means 2 depth. Next plus N means side slope 2 into D1 2. That is equal D1 square 2 square. That is equal 24 square meter area. It is the A1. Next cross section of head other end A2. Same BD2 plus ND2 square equal to 8 into 2.5 plus 2 into 2.5 square. That equal to 32.5 square meter. So here we find the A1 and A2. And this is taking average mean section area equal to AM, A1 plus A2 divided by 2, 24 plus A1, 24, A2 is the 32.5 divided by 2. That is equal to 28.25 square meter. Therefore, volume of the earthwork V equal to area into L, 28.25 into length is the 70. That is equal to 1977 point cubic meters. Okay. Next, we got this next problem. A canal is proposed to be excavated between two points A and B, 120 meters apart. If the bed's width is 10 meters, if the bed width is 10 meters, side slopes 1.5:1, and depth of cutting 1 meter, and 2 meters and 3 meters at the A, B, C. Calculate the quantity of earthwork excavation by mid-sectional area method and mean sectional area method. So the longitudinal section of the positions AC and cross section at ABC and midsection of the shown in figure. So here longitudinal section is total length A to C point, N point. So length is 120 meters. This is the longitudinal section. Here give the depth is at A and B at C. At depth of cutting 1 meter A and B is the 2 meters and C is 3 meters. It is the longitudinal section at A and B and C. And top width is 10 meters. So it is the cross section A, cross section B, cross section C. It is the longitudinal section. Here side slope is 1.5:1. Means 1.5 meters. Here and give the lengths are here 1.5, 1.5, 3, 3, and 4.5. This is the given data totally. These figures are also given. So here we find the midsection area method and mean section area method. So first of all, midsectional area method. So volume of earthwork B equal to mid cross sectional area into distance. Distance means L, cross sectional area means A. A into L. So first of all, area of the midsection AM, BD plus N into D means BD plus N square, where B equal to already given bed width 10 meters. B 10 meters and N equal to side slope 1.5:1, 1.5, and D equal to average depth 1 plus 3 divided by 2. Average depth is taken AN and last end, first end and last end. 1 plus 3 divided by 2, that equal 2 meters. AM equal to B is the 10 meters, substitute in formula N equal 1.5 into D 2, multiply with the D 2, that equal to 26 square meters. Therefore, volume equal to 26 into length, distance is 120 meters. That equal to 3120 cubic meters. It is the mid sectional area method. Next one, mean sectional area method. Same volume of the earthwork or quantity of the earthwork B equal to average of cross section A and distance L. So formula BD plus N into D square, that is equal to B 10 meters and N equal 1.5. Here depth D 1. Here find out the whole area at A. Here find out the areas individual A and B and C into 1, that equal to 11.5 square meters. Next one, area at B, B plus D into N into D. So base width 10 and next one N is the side slope 1.5 into D, depth at B 2 meters into D at B equal to 2 meters, that is equal to 26 square meters. Similarly, area at C, that equal to B plus ND into D. B value is the 10 plus 1.5 is the N value side slope into D 3 into D value 3. At C they get D 3 meters, that is equal to 43.50 meters. Then finally, average area. A, average area A equal to first area plus last area 11.50 plus 43.50 divided by 2, that equal 27.50 meter square. Volume V equal to 27.5 into length L 120, that equal to 3300 cubic meters. It is the area volume of the earthwork. Okay. Next problem. Write the problem. The ground levels along the center line of road is given below. So here chain age in meters and RL reduced level of ground. Chain age here 0, 50, 100, 150, 200. Means each distance taken points 50 meters each point. The road is formed in embankment with formation level at 100 meters throughout the length. If the width of road is 10 meters and the side slope 2:1, calculate the quantity of earthwork required by the trapezoidal and prismatic rule. Assume that traverse slope as level. This figure we draw. So here, given that 2:1 side slope and formation level is 100 meters and length means formation level is throughout the length 100 meters and width of road is the 10 meters. Side slope 2:1. So here we find the trapezoidal rule and prismatic rule. So first, height of the formation chain edge at zero, starting point zero, that equal to 100 minus 97.0, that equal to 3 meters. Right, understand, at zero level chain edge in meters, reduced level of ground 97 and formation level is the 100, formation level minus reduced level of the ground 97, that equal to 3 meters. It is the height of the bank, so it is the ground level. So we find the reduced level and formation level is given. Here formation level is 100. It is the formation level 100. Suppose this is 0 point and reduced of the ground level 96, 97, 98 and something. So we find the heights. Okay, it is the zero, next 50, next 100, next 150, next 200. So here formation level is first one broad arm of the ground 0 degrees, 0 meters, 97. Here 97. So here it is the RL of formation. And it is the RL of ground. It is the formation line, it is the ground line. So here we find the heights. 100 minus 97 equal to 3. Next one is the 96.50. Second one. Next one is the 96 at 100. Next one 97.5. And last 200 at 98. Is the 98 point. It is the 98.97.5, 96, 96.5, 97. So first one depth is, it is the height of the banks means chain edge at 0, 100 minus 97 equal to 3. Next similarly 100 minus 96.5 equal to 3.5. Next one 100 minus 96, 4. next 100 minus formation of RL of formation minus RL of ground 97.5, it is the 2.5. Next last one is the 100 minus 98, that is equal to 2. Okay, clearly it is the RL of formation and RL of ground, it is the chain edge zero level. Next one, area of the cross section A1 at chain edge 0, B plus ND into D, base value 10 into side slope 2 into depth value 3. Depth means it is the depth 3 into 3, that is equal to 48.0 square meters. Next one, A2, area of chain edge at 2, BD plus ND square or B plus ND into D. So 10 plus 2 into 3.5 equal to 3.5, that equal to 59.5 square meters. Similarly, A3 at chain edge 100 meters, 10 plus 4 into 4 means here 2. Side slope 2. So 2 into 4 into 4, that equals 72. Similarly, at chain edge 150 is 37.5 square meters. Next, at chain edge 200 meters, that equal to 10 plus 2 into 2 equal to 28 square meters. Trip JL formula, volume of earthwork equal to area by 2, first area plus remaining areas equal to last area by 2, or L into first area plus last area by 2. So this is the formula. L value 50 meters, 48 by 2, first area 48, and next 59.50 plus 72.5, the next A4 37.5, A5 is the 28 divided by 2, that equal to 10,350 cubic meters. It is the volume. The area means square meters, volume is cubic meter. So here, taking length is each chain edge level interval is the 50. So taking L value equal to 50. So 0 to 50 difference, 50 to 150, 100 to 50, 50. 150 to 200 difference is the 50. So taking L value is equal to 50. Next one is the prismoidal formula. So prismoidal formula, in find out the volume of the work. Formula is the L by 3 into first area plus last area into 4 into A2 plus A4 plus 2 A3. So L is equal to 50. A1 is the 48 and last area is the 28 plus 4 into A2 is the 59.5 plus A4 is the 37.5 plus 2 into A3. A3 equal to 72. Substitute values, L is 50 by 3. 48 plus 28 equal to 76. 388 plus 144. That is equal to 10,134 cubic meters. This is the volume of the earthwork in prismoidal formula. Okay, clear all of you? In this formula, we calculate the chain edge and RLF ground and RLF formation is given. We find the height of the back in meters, different heights. Okay, clear all of you? Okay, thank you very much, all of you. Any doubt in these problems? Okay, thank you.